And now it's my distinct honor to introduce our first speaker of the day. Karen Pulido was inaugurated on January 8, 2015 as the 72nd Lieutenant Governor of the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, having served previously in both the public and private sectors. Lieutenant Governor Pulido serves as co-chair of the STEM Advisory Council, along with Congressman Joe Kennedy, Vertex CEO Dr. Jeffrey Lydon. And she works hard to ensure that all students have access to comprehensive science, technology, engineering, and math education, and that they're inspired and prepared for careers in STEM fields. The administration is focused on closing the skills gap and recently expanded programming with local companies to offer high school students STEM internships. Lieutenant Governor Pulido is a graduate of Holy Name Central Catholic High School right here in Worcester, Boston College, and the New England School of Law, and she is a lifelong resident of Shrewsbury. Please join me in welcoming our Lieutenant Governor, Karen Pulido.
Thanks, Doug. Appreciate it. Good morning, everyone. I'm so happy to be here at hometown to welcome you all to the 14th STEM Summit. If you get a little, feel like you're cramped in here, although I don't see how you could. You could always go to the Railers game that's taking place at 10 o'clock, our local ice hockey team. I'm just saying thank you from the bottom of my heart for what each one of you is doing in your respective school, in your school district, in your community, in this Commonwealth. You are sort of the pioneers in many respects in your community who have decided to take this status quo and disrupt it in a positive way, to take on more, to do more, to prepare the kids that you come in contact with for careers that are growing and that are available here in this Commonwealth, in this country, and places around this world. I come to this summit and I get quite inspired by you and the work that you do. In fact, I'm thrilled that Kathleen Malone will be recognized today by Brian Morey, Teacher of the Year, STEM teacher from Derby in Hingham. Great job, you're an inspiration to us. Yvonne Spicer, who is a newly elected mayor and now the city of Framingham, and your work is pioneering. Thank you for your work. I do want to thank our sponsors, obviously Doug for leading us today, the Business Roundtable, our STEM Council, and of course the UMass Donahue Institute deserves a lot of credit for their whole team who has organized the room, the exhibit room, and of all of the panel programs today. They are outstanding. I scanned the list and I wish I could be here with you all day to enjoy them. I just want to give a shout out to one group that I saw downstairs, and I think this was part of the call as a mother that I was drawn to this particular exhibit, and it's called Little Miss Science, and there are three young women from Marlboro High School that started up a program in their community. There you go. Marblehead, right? And Marlboro, right? I know your program too. But they're just three girls who said, I wish that I had this exposure earlier in my life, but anyway, I'm in high school and I want girls younger than me to have some exposure to the STEM projects. And I want to make it fun so they actually engage in the work to develop skills for STEM careers. I want to thank my partners in the STEM Advisory Council. Congressman Joe Kennedy has been a terrific partner, really working hard with our team and bringing attention and spotlighting the work that we're doing in our Commonwealth and talking about it in his travels. And Jeffrey Lydon of Vertex, who has been such a strong proponent of STEM and really putting his words into action by starting an internship program for high school students in his workplace that's really very progressive and is really making a huge difference. So I just want to put in perspective of why this is so important, what you're doing each and every day, why you're here at the STEM Summit, and why when you leave here, the work that you're doing is very important for the future success of our Commonwealth. And also to highlight the fact that the work that you have been doing and those that have come before you has really made a difference here in our Commonwealth. So many of you know that Massachusetts is a world leader when it comes to innovation in our innovation economy and education. We are number one in the country for our innovation economy. Nearly 50% of our workforce has college degrees. That's number one in the country. 33% more workers in math and computer science occupations. That's more than the national average. 2 times the number of system software developers. We lead the country in terms of our career, vocational and technical education, winning 36 medals in the national 2017 SkillsUSA competitions. And there are more accolades, but they're all adding up in a way that Massachusetts is being looked upon as an education and eco center. And people are trying to learn what we're doing here. Because really, the most important asset that we have in this Commonwealth are our people. And when we're investing and skilling them in a way that is attracting employers and startup companies to grow their companies here in Massachusetts, because you are graduating and preparing kids with the skills to match those jobs, is really impactful. Yet while we're doing all of this, when Charlie and I travel this Commonwealth, we still hear from too many employers who say, we have jobs to fill, and we cannot find enough people with the skills to fill these jobs. So too many good-paying jobs are still going unfilled, and many of these opportunities are in the STEM fields. Over the past 5 years, the number of post-secondary STEM certificates and degrees has only grown by 2 percentage points and still comprises less than 1/3 of all the certificates and degrees conferred in this state. So that just tells you there is more work to do, and that is exactly why you're here today. I do want to also point out that the road ahead of us, over the next 10 years, U.S. industries will need 1 million more. 1 million more STEM graduates than our system will generate. So we're a pretty competitive bunch here in Massachusetts, and we want to make sure that we're doing everything we can to grow a talent pipeline that will address this skills gap and these jobs that are growing. Because the more rapid we can close that gap, the more competitive we will be as a Commonwealth. And that means your kids, not only your own at home, but your kids in your classroom and in your school district and my 2 children, they'll have opportunities right here in this Commonwealth. And this is where they can begin their careers around jobs that pay pretty good. And they can lay their own roots in a community where they grew up and have ties. And when that next generation that you're preparing stays here in this Commonwealth with their skills and their talent and their connections, it really does make for a strong Commonwealth for our future. So some of the things that we've been able to do first when we came into office was form a workforce skills cabinet. That's our labor, workforce and development secretary, our education secretary, and our economic development secretary. And they've worked together to figure out how to close this gap. One of the things they discovered and they've acted on with the help of our legislature was to make sure that we're funding equipment to embed in your classrooms, CNC machines, 3D printers, software programs, in your classrooms, turning them into laboratories, turning them into what the workplace of today looks like, so that your kids have applied learning opportunities, hands-on, problem-solving, having fun doing it, working on a team, and developing skills that are critical for the future. We turned our STEM Advisory Council into an executive office function. So we put it right into Secretary Pizer's shop to be able to put critical attention on STEM development. We've also been the first state with K-12 curriculum standards for technology and engineering. And last year, we adopted computer science and digital literacy standards, as well as a new set of academic standards for K-12 science, technology, and engineering, which are based on a modified version of the Next Generation Science Standards. We strive for the best. high standards work. These are complicated standards to embed into your curriculum and into your work, but you're doing it and you're making a difference, and we thank you for doing that. We also have been able to, in our second year, is to partner with Project Lead the Way. They have an exhibit downstairs. You'll be hearing from them on one of their panels. And they are doing a terrific job, and we recently awarded them $1 million through our STEM Council, along with the 1-8 Foundation, to fund 45 schools across the district to expand computer science, biomedical science, and engineering education for students in K-12. So take advantage of these funds and what the Project Lead the Way has to offer in not only high school, but down into the middle school and elementary schools and early education in this Commonwealth. And in the coming weeks, you'll hear us talk more so about computer science. You know, when you take an industry like cybersecurity, and that we are in this Commonwealth through an executive order of the governor, really zeroing in on cybersecurity. I mean, our whole life centers around technology, your smartphone, your devices. And just think how vulnerable we are at the same time. We have about 8,000 jobs currently that we need to fill. In the industry of cybersecurity alone, we have a pipeline of about 4,000 people skilled in computer science to address those jobs in cybersecurity. That means we have about 4,000 that we don't have enough people with the right skills to fill, as an example. So we will be awarding and announcing that we are going to fund the training of 100 teachers in AP computer science principles over the next 2 years. And then, so we'll continue to stay focused. You know, doing more of what works, works. You're doing what works, and we need to double down on that. And our STEM Council will stay focused like a laser beam on work-based learning programs. Early college, taking high school credits, applying them to college, and creating that pathway for students is really critical. The high quality computer science and engineering curricula, as we've referenced, and the STEM networks. Let's give a shout out to the regional STEM networks for the great work they're doing across our Commonwealth. And finally, the summit's theme this year is very appropriate: progress through partnerships. Partnerships work. You don't have to feel like you're going this alone. Certainly partnerships between state and your community, you know, partnerships together, learning from each other, and then certainly partnerships with our employers. The STEM at Work initiative that we started through the council is critical. That's why I wanted to give a shout out to Vertex. They have created a model student internship program and accompanied by a $500 million investment in STEAM education. And they're opening up opportunities by their own example to local companies like Lampen Corporation of Northbridge, Omni Control Technology of Uxbridge. These are employers in our communities. All 351 cities and towns have employers that need to have a connection to a skilled workforce. And in this case, we've been able to focus on these paid high school internships, not just waiting until college. Work with the kids in high school to make sure that they know about the workplaces of today. And if we can connect more employers to the classroom and more kids in the classroom to the workplace, we will do a better job of creating that pipeline of talent that will stay here. In fact, this past year, we were able to engage 26 new employers in 54 new paid student placements, all in the area of STEM. And they attended by nearly 100 educators in 4 regional roundtables to engage in that conversation about how to make these connections and build this partnership between employers and our students. So we need to keep doing that, and we need to keep making sure that whether it's Thermo Fisher or Waters Corporation or one of your local employers that might be a little smaller or a startup company, that they understand making that connection to your students is really a great opportunity. I also want to just acknowledge Alexis Lian. She's of our STEM Council. She's here, and she has all of the information available to you for these internship opportunities, and I hope that you'll keep that in your mind as you come across a student in your high school that could benefit from one kind of internship like this and help us identify employer partners in your community that could participate as well. We are doing great work here in this Commonwealth. I am very proud of you. And I know Governor Baker and I and our entire cabinet are very appreciative of your work. You are the reason why we are having and experiencing a strong economy in Massachusetts, because of the people that you are graduating with the skills to become employed in this Commonwealth. So today's message is one of partnership, and it's one of appreciation and thanks, and one of keep doing what you're doing because it's working well here for Massachusetts. Have a great day, and thank you.